Hey everyone, it's Keri from Salesflare, and today I'm going to teach you how the Insights dashboard works. To start, you have two tabs up top. The Revenue tab is more of a financial overview, while the Team tab gives you an idea of team performance and activity. You can also change the period of the insights you're viewing over here. For example, to go back in time to last quarter or how you're doing 2 months ago. There's also a custom option for if you have a different fiscal year or if you want to see insights from a specific week or few days, for instance. You can also change the view from team level to different user groups or on an individual level as well. And you can view one specific pipeline for insights, or you can view all pipelines together. Here you have your revenue insights. At the top here, most of these are self-explanatory. You have your revenue you've brought in this period compared to last period, as well as the number of won opportunities this period and the number of new ones. You have here your average sales cycle. That is the average days until you close a deal. That's the amount of days from the date that you create the opportunity to the date that you move it to won, aka the close date. Here you have your average value of a won deal. This is calculated by taking the revenue you've brought in divided by the number of won opportunities. Down here you have expected revenue versus revenue goal. This number here shows what you've already sold, and you have the black line which shows your target that you can set in settings, set target. And down here shows the expected revenue that you think you'll bring in this period. This is calculated by taking the value in a stage times the probability that deals in that stage will make it to one, and then added all the stages together. This is something that you can set in settings, configure pipelines. Next, you have revenue versus previous period, or in this case, month. This shows you the changes based on the period. So you always have an idea, in this period, how did I do in different parts of the period? How did I do relative to last period? The revenue number listed is the change in revenue. If you hover over last period, which is the light blue bar, it'll show you the period by date and the revenue that you made. Same for the dark blue, except for this is the period that you selected up top. Top earning accounts. These are calculated by the total sum of all won opportunities per account, then listed with the account with the biggest in terms of revenue at the top. Down here, we have top lost reasons. These shows that the opportunities that are lost and the most common reason it was lost at the top. The percentage shows you the amount of opportunities that were lost for that specific reason. This can help you learn how to improve your sales. Funnel analysis. The black number on the left states how many opportunities are in each stage. The plus or minus sign to the right of it is compared to the last period. And the percentage numbers here show the change in the number of opportunities compared to the last stage. And lastly, we have monthly recurring revenue. This only appears if you have recurring revenue turned on for that pipeline. You can turn recurring revenue on for the pipelines in settings, configure pipelines. Just click on the pencil icon next to the pipeline stage name. This graph shows the sum of all monthly subscriptions that are running in that period. Here you have your team insights. Up top, you have most active rep. This is calculated by counting the sum of all activities, so all emails plus phone calls plus meetings. The most sold rep is the user on your team that's won the most opportunities in this period. Then you have the average sent emails, phone calls, and meetings based on the team. Down here you have leaderboard quota per rep. Every rep gets a certain quota or target, and this graph shows how the rep is performing versus the quota that is set for them. This black line is the target that is set for the rep per period. Next, you have closing percentage per rep. Out of all the opportunities that each team member makes, this shows how many they're closing. The black line represents the team average, and the green and red figure shows the comparison to last period. Activity per rep. This gives you a per rep view on how many tracked emails were sent, how many phone calls were logged, and how many meetings were had. Down here, you have slipping deals. The way it works is when you have had no interaction with an account and there's an opportunity linked to that account that is not yet won or lost in the pipeline, it will appear here. And lastly, we have closing percentage. This shows the distribution of where people are on your team in terms of closing percentage. So this black number shows the average closing percentage per team. And when you hover over, you can see the amount of reps that are closing in this range and the closing percentages that define that range. Okay, that's all I have for you today on Insights. As always, if you have any more questions, you can always reach me down here on the chat. Thanks for watching.